Hebrews chapter 10 and verse 25 says, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together, as is the manner of some, but exhorting one another, and so much the more as you see the day approaching. So Paul is saying, you know, do not forsake the assembling of ourselves, assembling of yourselves together. So get together and don't stop being the church. So when we get discouraged, or sometimes when we fall into sin or into some sinful pattern or lifestyle, that is when we tend to stay away from the fellowship of other believers. That is when we tend to stay away from church. And there could be other reasons why we tend to stay away from church. It could be that we get discouraged, that our faith is not working as we see it working in other people's lives. Or it could be that we are ashamed, that we are struggling with some secret sin and we don't want others to know about it. Hebrews 10:25 again, it says, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together, as is the manner of some, but exhorting one another, and so much more as you see the day approaching. So this assembling together of people, there are all kinds of people. People who are mature, people who are immature, people who are struggling, people who are victorious. But irrespective of where we are as believers, the writer of Hebrews is saying, exhorting, encouraging us, meet together. Now, that word forsaking, it's made up of three different words which mean out, down, behind. You know, all these three put together. Typically describing someone who is actually down and out, who's left out, maybe feeling down, and who's left behind. And these could be reasons why a person would give in to Satan's suggestions or give in to his own flesh, the suggestions of the flesh, saying, I need to stay away from church and I need to isolate myself from other believers and maybe just stay at home and read the Bible or, you know, and things like that. But the fact is that the fellowship of other believers is essential to receive encouragement. When we get together as a church, when we worship the Lord together corporately, you know, we experience the presence of God in a very tangible way, in a very different way from the times when we worship Him alone. Yes, it's important that we worship Him alone as believers, but when we gather together as a family, we experience the presence and the power of God in a totally different way. And then we get an opportunity to declare prophetic words or to receive prophetic words from people. And we know that prophecy edifies and encourages and brings edification and comfort into a person's life. So we receive divine edification, divine comfort, divine exhortation, and we receive prophetic words. And also we receive prayer and encouragement in a church, maybe a word of knowledge, a word of wisdom, a counsel, or just the fact that we have a shoulder to cry on and we have an opportunity to be heard, to just unload our cares, our burdens. So all this happens in the fellowship of believers. So may we never forsake the assembling together as a church. Let's pray. Father, we pray that no matter what reason, no matter what we go through, that we will not forsake the assembling together, that we will not God, give up on assembling together as a church, as meeting as a church, God. I pray, Lord, all that you have designed, Lord, in the body, that we should receive as members of the body. I pray, God, may you release that, O God, even today and in the days ahead. We thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.